The materials that I use to make this cute little Beetlejuice pumpkin are 3 size 4 weight yarns. Use bargain friendly yarns. This is not something you really want to go bougie on. We have some options here. So I have black. This is Red Heart Super Saver. White, and you want stark white, not an off white. You want as white as you can possibly get in order to match those Beetlejuice colors. This is, I love this yarn. And then a green, and I have here Mainstay, and it is just color green. So I wanted to just show you, you don't have to use exactly the brands that I use, but that you have options here when it comes to a size 4 weight yarn and bargain friendly. The crochet hook that I'm using is an I9 or 5.5 millimeter. You got the yarn needle, you have a pair of scissors, and you need some kind of polyfill or stuffing so that way we can give our pumpkin some structure. Go ahead and gather everything and then let's get started. Let's start by chaining 20. One, two, three, four, five, six, 19 and 20. Great. For row one, we're going to make a half double crochet stitch in the second chain from our crochet hook. One, two, yarn over, half double crochet. Yes, I'm working with black first, so if it's difficult to see what I'm doing, just listen to what I'm saying. We are making one half double crochet stitch in every chain all the way across for row one. You should end row one with a total of 19 half double crochet stitches. Great, so that is row one. For row two, we're gonna stick with the black color, chain one, turn our work, and for row two, we're going to make one half double crochet in the back loop only of every stitch all the way across. Yarn over, find the V stitch at the top of the work, insert your crochet hook into the back loop only, yarn over, pull through, and then yarn over, pull through all the loops on your hook. Continue on. You should end row two with a total of 19 half double crochet stitches in the back loop only. And 19. Great. After two rows of one color, we're going to grab our scissors, cut a short tail, nothing too crazy. Tie off your work by yarning over, pulling that yarn through the loop on your hook, and pulling tight for a little slip knot. Then go ahead and turn your work so that last stitch we just finished is on our working side, and grab the white color. We're going to do two rows of black, two rows of white, two rows of black, two rows of white, and that is going to be the repeat pattern. Slip stitch into the very first stitch. Go ahead and work underneath both loops only just to attach the new color to the project. Then chain one and find the back loop only of that V. And we're going to half double crochet in that back loop only. If it'll help you out to slip stitch into the back loop only and not underneath both loops, then go ahead and do that. Just whatever will work best for you. And then make one half double crochet in the back loop only of every stitch all the way across. And then with the next row, you're going to chain one and stick with the same white and make one half double crochet in the back loop only of every stitch across. Again, you're going to switch colors just like we showed here every two rows. Continue this pattern until you reach the end of row 24 and then stop. And I will meet up with you at the end of row 24 to show you what we will do next in the process. Once we've made it to row 24, we can actually just go ahead and cut our yarn, leaving a long enough tail for us to join the top last row, row 24, with row 1 to make a little circle. So I'm going to go ahead and just give myself a bunch of slack. Err on too much, so that way you don't have to add any more yarn, but there's nothing wrong with adding more yarn if you do run out. Tying off our work, grabbing our yarn needle, threading that through. Now what's great about this particular creation is we have all these tails on the bottom, but we don't have to worry about them. Don't weave them in. It's fine. We're going to take care of them. Don't have to worry. I'm going to flip it so that way my yarn is starting in the direction where I can move naturally. Join row one, or our foundation row, with our row 24, aligning the stitches. And then I'm just going to do a whip stitch. And if you're unfamiliar with a whip stitch, we're just going to take our yarn and go over to the front, insert into that first loop of our foundation row, and through to that first stitch, and pull through. But I want to guide my loop where it lands, so that way it'll go where I want. Otherwise, it's going to end up over there or in other places you don't want it to be. Then take your yarn, again, bring it to the front. Sometimes I'll wrap it around my hand to help me out. Insert into the second loop of the foundation, insert into the second stitch, and pull through. And you can pull tight, so that way it hides that a little bit. And then repeat all the way down, joining the foundation row to row 24. Great, last stitch there. And I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna tie a knot here at the very end, so I don't have to worry or fuss with this. So I'm gonna take my yarn, I'm gonna wrap around my finger, insert back into that same stitch, hold the loop back, take this loop, and I'm gonna twist it. Take my yarn needle, go underneath the loop, and slowly guide it. And that forms that slip knot. And now I can walk away and it's tight, it's secure. Looking at the top of our pumpkin, or our creation so far, you should have a cylinder. Just this nice little circle right here. We're gonna cinch the top up. So I'm gonna take my yarn needle and my yarn. I'm going to keep this tail on the inside. Right now I'm looking on the wrong side of the project, or the inside of the project. So keep the tails all on this outside. Taking my yarn needle, I'm going to go in the side of one row, then come to the second row, and come out. And then I'm just going to go in and out, weaving in and out of rows. So next row, in, next row, out. You don't want to put more than one stitch per row, because it'll end up being too much and the cinch won't be the same. Okay, continue all the way around. Last stitch here, coming through. Great. Hold the yarn back and pull, and it'll close that top. Fantastic. Now to secure it, I can either tie a knot with this tail, which is probably the most secure way of doing this, or I could do another slip knot, whichever way works best for you or that you feel most comfortable. Great. If you notice after cinching that there's still a hole at the bottom here that has not closed, it's still a gap here and it's bothering you, take your yarn needle and just go through rows from one side to the next, then come over and just sew that hole closed with what is left of the yarn on your yarn needle, and then just tie your slip knot. Great. Release the yarn from your yarn needle, and you don't even have to weave in an end or cut that. You can just leave that alone. This is the inside of the pumpkin, so I'm gonna take my hand, I'm gonna pinch the bottom, I'm gonna flip it. And all of these tails that I see, all of these amazing tails, we're just gonna stuff those on the inside. Don't worry about weaving them in. It's all going to be used and concealed on the inside of the pumpkin. Now we are also going to grab our polyfill and start stuffing. When you stuff, you actually want to stuff on the lighter side. If you overstuff, and what will happen is it'll stretch the stitches, and if it stretches the stitches, you'll be able to see the polyfill on the inside, and it's kind of an eyesore. It doesn't look clean. So we want to have just enough where we can give it some structure, but not so much where we can't close the top. We want to be able to close the top. Then grabbing our yarn, cutting just a long enough strand for us to weave and cinch the top. Thread my yarn needle, and you can attach the yarn anywhere you want. I'm just gonna go ahead and start. Oh, let's go ahead and just attach it right there. And knot so it doesn't go anywhere. and weave or cinch. So in and out. And made it all the way around. Fantastic. Making sure all those tails are on the inside and then pulling to cinch that closed. Awesome. Now I'm not done with this. I want to keep this long tail. I just want to make a slip knot, create a knot, so that way I can release my yarn and it's not going to open the top of the pumpkin. Okay. I slowly guide so I know that knot will hit right where I want it to. Now some people stop right here, so if you're okay with a ball-shaped pumpkin, then you can stop right here. Me, I like to give this pumpkin a little more shape. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my yarn needle, I'm gonna insert it into the middle of the top and bring it through the middle of the bottom and pull, and when I pull, it gives it that little dimple. And then I'll take my yarn needle and I'll go back. I'll insert it on the other side of where I entered and go back through to the top. Great. And so it's got an even little dimple on the bottom as well. And tie my knot. Now you could either stop here and be good, or you could do the next step, which is to add little sections of our pumpkin to give it kind of little indents. And this is super easy peasy. You can take your yarn and your needle, if you have enough, line it up either in the middle of the black or the middle of the white, like that. I'm gonna go ahead and go black to black so you can't see. And then come in the middle of the bottom and poke the top, and then when you pull, it makes that little dent. It's so cool. And then I'm not gonna do every black one. You can if you want. I'm gonna go ahead and do every other. Now I'm gonna make a knot so I can wrap this up. Great. Now I have this tail that I released. You can grab your crochet hook, insert your crochet hook somewhere into the side of the pumpkin, and come out the top. There we go. See right there? I'm gonna grab that tail with the hook on my crochet hook and just pull that tail on the inside of the pumpkin. Again, nothing to weave in. We're good. The next step that we are going to make is the stem. Go ahead and grab your green color. Same crochet hook, and we're going to start by chaining 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. For row 1, we're going to single crochet in the second chain and in each chain across for a total of 5 single crochet stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. For row 2 and 3, we're going to do the same thing. Just chain 1, turn our work, and make 1 single crochet stitch in each stitch across. And 5. We're going to join the foundation row with row 3 to make a little round stem. So I'm going to chain 1 and turn my work. I'm going to bring row 1, or the foundation row, up, inserting my crochet hook into that foundation loop and into the first stitch, and slip stitch. And repeat underneath the next loop, into the next stitch, yarn over, pull through, and slip stitch all the way across. Total of 5 of these. And then I'm going to do one more on the very top to just kind of cap off the top. So I'm going to find this loop that's just kind of sticking out here, go underneath that loop, and the side or the very top, however you can find, to just make one more slip stitch there at the top to give it that pointed finished off look.
Kind of looks like a pea pod.
And then cut a short tail because we're just gonna tuck that tail in. Yarn over and pull through. And then I can insert my yarn or my crochet hook there in the center. Pop it out, yarn over, and pull through. There we go. Just like that. Now with these two tails, we're going to attach this stem to the top of our pumpkin. Okay, so taking our yarn needle, come to the top of the pumpkin. Go. Okay, gonna go one more. There we are. And then I'm gonna grab the other tail just for like a dual secure hold here. And then I'm going to release my yarn needle. I'm gonna take my two tails. I'm gonna tie a knot with them for extra security. Great, and then I'm gonna take my crochet hook, insert it into the pumpkin. Oh, I love stuffed animals for this because we don't have to worry about weaving in any ends. We just pull everything on the inside. Then yarn, grab those tails with the claw of our hook and just pull them in. There we go. Now, an extra thing that I thought would be fun for our pumpkin is to add a little corkscrew vine to make the vine. I'm gonna take that green color. We're gonna chain 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 11, and 12. In the second chain from our crochet hook, we're gonna make 2 single crochet stitches. 1, 2, and in each chain, we're going to make 2 single crochet stitches. This is gonna cause some crowding, which will create that corkscrew look. You're gonna end row 1 with a total of 22 single crochet stitches. 21 and 22. Cut a tail long enough for us to sew this stem, this little vine onto our pumpkin. Then yarn over and pull through the loop on our hook for a tie off. Now, right now it doesn't look very corkscrewy, but if you take it, it's actually very moldable. Isn't that cute? Awesome. Grabbing our yarn needle, coming right at the base of the stem. I'm gonna come through with one tail and then drop it. I'm gonna grab the other tail and I'm going to insert my yarn needle in the opposite direction of the first tail, that how it came through. And this is gonna help the base of the this vine to attach as securely and closely as possible. I'm gonna come underneath the vine and tie a knot. If you would like to go through the vine a couple of times with your yarn, you're more than welcome to do that. And then taking my crochet hook, there we go. Straighten out the stem of my pumpkin, get my little curly Q right there. And that is how you make this Beetlejuice pumpkin. So cute.